Hello guys, as a part of interview experience series, Pranita is here, who got placed in Infosys. And I like to add that she is also one of the best singer in our college. Before moving to the discussion with her, those who are new to the channel, please subscribe to our channel now. Hi Pranita.
Hi Nimal.
Yeah, thanks for accepting our invitation to share your interview experience.
Yeah, I've seen many videos of you. You guys are really doing great job. So I want to be part of your channel.
Okay. First of all, how you got attendance opportunity of Infosys?
It was a pool drive, actually. So and there is an eligibility criteria, like we should meet 60% above. So I have met all the criteria they mentioned. So TPO let me know that I have met the criteria, so I have attended and I have gone through that.
Okay, then how you prepared for attendance?
Yeah, I have seen many previous year papers, videos in YouTube, and also I have attended the training sessions conducted in our college, and I have also practiced to get command on aptitude and quants.
Okay, then. Okay, what is the Infosys written test pattern? I mean, how many sections are there like that?
Yeah, there are three sections in this written test. The first section is quants. So in that, there are 10 questions. Each one carries 1 mark. And these 10 questions should be answered in 35 minutes. So in these 10 questions, first 5 questions will be on arrangements, in my case, considering. Arrangement means a paragraph will be given, and in that 5 sub questions will be there, and another 5 questions, one may be on profit and loss, one may be on percentages, and all the major topics like ratios and proportions, speed, time and distance, and so on. Next second section will be on logical reasoning. In this 15 questions will be there, and it should be answered in 25 minutes. So from these 15 questions, in my case, first 5 questions on data interpretation, and next 5 questions on data sufficiency, and another 5 questions on one on syllogisms and on cryptarithmetic questions. So here, cryptarithmetic question is a common question in many previous years I have seen. And next section is verbal pack. So for every section, there will be sectional cutoff, and there is no section switching and also no negative marking. So considering sectional cutoff, let us consider first section. It has 10 questions. So we should get at least 6 marks. That means 60% we should get at least. Next, second section contains 15 questions. We should get 9 marks. And also third section, 40 questions. And we should get 24 marks. So this is the toughest part, I can say. Because in verbal part, we have major sections like error identification, error correction, reading comprehension. So in reading comprehensions, we have to invest more time. So here, time management is more important. So that is the toughest part.
I like to add one more point is that there was a change in written test pattern this year. There will be 2 more sections like puzzle solving and pseudocode. So I already made a video on latest recruitment process of Infosys. So the students can go through the link provided in description later. Then in how many days you got result of written test?
Today I've attended the written test, and the next day I got a mail that you have cleared the test, written test, and you have to attend the further process on the next day.
Yeah, okay. Actually, you take a written test at another campus, right? But
yeah.
I think here, because of this pandemic situation, students have to go through online test in the presence of webcam. Okay. Then did they specify any requirements before moving to interview process?
Yeah, they have asked me to bring my college ID card and grade cards till the semester, and 10th and 12th certificates, and these 3 are compulsory.
Yeah, okay. Then how many rounds are there in interview process?
Yeah, generally, there are 2 rounds, TR and HR. But in my case, there is only 1 round, single round, which is combined TR and HR.
Okay, then. Can you share me some of the questions that you got faced in interview process?
Yeah, sure. Since it is a combined TR and HR process, so he asked some basic questions. First, it is a, considering HR, he started to ask my introduction. He asked me to introduce myself And after that, he went into some technical stuff. He asked me to explain my project. At the time, I have not done my major project yet. So I've explained my mini project and internship project based on machine learning. And he asked some basic questions on C programming, like to write a function on quicksort, which comes under data structures. And he asked me to explain about a correlated subquery, which is under DBMS. And he also asked me to explain about STLC steps, software development lifecycle steps, which comes under software engineering. So he touched major parts of the basic concepts. So we should know at least a basic of our academic subjects, so we can easily clear.
Yeah, okay. Then what is the role and salary that you got?
Yeah, my role is a system engineer, SE, and package is 3.6 LPA.
Yeah, okay. Pranita, you already attempted a TCS NQT, right? So there are some sections like active reasoning, verbal, which is common, info is written test also. So comparing to TCS, NQT and Infosys pool drive, which was harder?
Infosys is hard, I can say, because in TCS NQT, there will be negative marking. Because of negative marking, there is a sectional cutoff is very, very low, I can say. But here, 60% should be cleared. In Infosys, 60% should be cleared in every section. So it is the toughest part. And also in TCS and QT, programming level is medium, I can say. But here, non-IT people can also crack in Infosys. And also here, clearing in verbal part is very tough, because we have to invest more time on reading comprehensions. If we spend more time on grammatical part, reading comprehensions does not get more time to answer the questions. So it is the toughest part.
Yeah, as there was no programming section in Infosys, so CSE and IIT students have no chance to do coding, right? Which was easy for them. Okay, yeah. Then, I done with my questions. Is there any suggestions from you to the students who are going for placement this year?
Yeah. I have to convey three things. First thing is perfection on what language you have learned. That means if you know C, Java, you have to be perfect on that. Next, try to learn any new technologies and try to know how it is applicable on the market. Next, the second thing is attend the training classes. I won't say that you completely depend on those classes, but I can say you can learn some methods and shortcuts to solve the problems in an easiest way. So they'll be helpful to attend the exam in an easiest way. Next, the third thing is good fluency in English. So if you're an average intellect, you can crack the test, any test.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Pranita, for sharing your interview experience with us.
Thank you. Hope you guys do more and more videos. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.